responsibility to minimize waste impact on the environment. Points of inquiry. What is waste? Resources that we waste. How waste affects the environment. Various kinds of pollution caused due to overcome of resources. Why is consumption of resources the need of the hour?
Now we present to you all the inquiry cycle. We saw the positive and negative forms of the human impact on the planet. We wondered how the waste generated by us could be reduced, reused and recycled. We investigated. We researched on different methods to reuse the materials and how to make the best out of waste. We explored through a lecture by Ms. Srikala Madam, our senior school science teacher. We explored how waste affects our environment and how can we save our earth. We also researched on various ways to save our earth.
We discovered reusing some of reducing and recycling it to produce best out of waste. We reflected that by applying the 3 R's in our lives, we can bring a positive change in the environment. We change that in our daily lives as responsible citizens
of the world
to save this planet.
We now present
the various findings of our research in a skit form.
Hello parents, and welcome to our 4th Culinary Lecture. Today, the whole world is facing a universal problem which they are trying to bring under control. A problem which is shown in the air, which is full of chemicals. Water, a precious limited resource which is full of poisonous chemicals, which comes from those factories who do not know what to do with their waste. Yes, you all have guessed it. We all of us are facing the dangers of pollution all around us.
Pollution is the air we breathe. The water we use, even the soil we grow our plants in, all this at a rate faster than man can control or can change. Yes, if each of us try in small little steps, each of us can save our beautiful earth from the monster called pollution.
We, students of MBIS, have been learning how we can stop this waste at an individual level. We have also been learning how to improve our environment and would like to share it with all of you. Some ideas about it with us.
Scene 1.
What are triple R's?
I think I missed learning about it in class. Where is Bhargavi? She should know all about it. She keeps reading on it all about it.
Oh yes, but I wonder, where is Bhargavi? She's late today. She has missed the assessment and is going to miss this culmination too. This looks like it.
The traffic, the smog, the noise.
Well, we are late to school today. You missed the maths assessment too.
Yes, Vaid. I was feeling sick when I got up this morning. I suffer from asthma and there was so much dust and smoke flying about all on the roads. And the traffic was bad as usual. And all that non-stop honking has given me a very bad headache.
So many cars on the road. Of course, there will be air and noise pollution. Driving through the Mumbai smoke, pollution and constant honking can make anyone sick.
You know, there is a solution to this.
What?
Perhaps we MBIS students can form a carpool with other classmates to stay in the same locality. It would mean less cars on the road, right? That was telling me recently in Delhi, many people did that and reduced the pollution to quite an extent.
Imagine the amount of petrol our parents can save if we have such an arrangement. A country can also save a petrol, and those who stay close by, they can just walk up. After all, what better starts to a day than a nice brisk walk?
Yes,
Petrol is a fast disappearing precious resource which is in very limited quantity on Earth, and we have to save this precious resource for the future generations. Do you know what is a non-renewable resource? It means a resource as oil, natural gases and coal is considered as non-renewable resources, which cannot be readily replaced by natural means because its formation takes billions of years to form again.
Yeah, yes, Marty, you know that you read up a lot. Now, Bhargavi, great idea. I will surely tell my father about it. This way, each of us can reduce at least 3-4 cars on the road.
Air pulling will also help reduce the air pollution and all that crazy pom-pom. Okay, that's a promise then. Let's give a clap on that.
As you saw, they have enlightened us in a small way how we can help in controlling air and noise pollution. Air pollution can be the cause of major lung diseases, and noise pollution can be the cause of deafness and stress.
Yes, right. Recently, the Mumbai Traffic Department has laid down guidelines on how much volume the horns of various vehicles have been permitted for cars which only 82 decibels. The PMC are also regularly testing the level of pollutants in the air by PUC.
My friends have contributed to help controlling pollution. So let's say 3 cheers for them. Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! See you in 2. Darshan.
But Vedan, that is only one part of the pollution. What about the waste we generate? Grade 3 students are smart. They know all about that too.
See you too. Lunchtime.
The day man was telling us that there are some things which disappear or decompose. Bio. What was the word she said? Biodegradable. See, that's the word. I read recently on the internet that bottles and cans take thousands of years to biodegrade. You are only confusing me. But I think some of our classmates are just talking about that. Come, let us hear what they have to tell.
Students are having wasteful energy. It was Prisha having a packet of wafers and drinking a can of juice. As she finishes, she throws it in the dustbin. No lunch today either, Prisha. All that chips and sugary juices are only making you put on your way. Do you know?
Why can't you carry a lunchbox with proper healthy lunch rather than eating that junk food?
What's wrong with that? And I did throw it in a dustbin.
Yes, you did. But this was only one packet of chips and one bottle of juice.
Exactly. Imagine you alone generate 500 grams of waste for every day. A family of 4 generates 2 kgs of waste per day. A society of 100 people generates 200 kgs of waste per day. And a whole city generates 1.
Oh my god! Wait. I do not make all that rubbish, and that's astonishing. So what happens to all that trash?
From a small house in various societies and school dustbin, it is cleared daily into a bigger locality dustbin, from where it is taken by huge lorries.
Oh yeah, Omanchi, I have seen those lorries by the name of cleaners.
That's right, and they pick up all the garbage and empty it down into a huge landfill area on the outskirts of the city.
So that's great. We don't have to worry about it anymore. What's the tension then?
Well, that's not true. Do you know what happens to the rubbish there, Shisha?
No.
Some waste like vegetable and fruit peelings, paper and food starts to rot as it is biodegradable.
What? What?
Biodegradable, Prisha. It means those substances can be broken down into little bits by the bacteria, which then gets decomposed in the soil to be used up by other organisms. But not all materials are like that.
Exactly. Man-made materials such as glass, metal, plastic, like those which you just threw in the bin, can take years and years, in fact thousands of years, to rot or degrade.
hence they are called non-biodegradable.
Oh, but the worst is still there. The landfills keep piling up and start releasing harmful gases, mainly one, called methane. This is slowly increasing our dangerous global warming. Now don't talk about this global warming, Pisha. Ma'am will be very upset that we forget all about it so soon.
That's right. And of course, we are running out of space to dump all this waste, especially if we consider like you how many students are dumping waste.
Oh my god! And that was really an eye-opener. And I thought the Nimba cleanup vans did a needful work. I don't have to care a bit about it. To imagine I'm creating 15 kgs of rubbish. Oh my god, 15 kgs? Thanks my friends for letting me know all this. I'll surely share this information with all my friends in the society to reduce the use of plastic and metal and henceforth bring a different way to lunchbox. Bring a lunchbox with healthy food.
As they are finishing lunch, Dane walks to Hans and opens the tap to wash his hands and walks off without closing it.
Hi Suhan, you did not close the tap. What a waste.
Oh, I forgot. Big deal.
It is a big deal. We are running out of drinking water. And on our own planet, soon it will be our generation which is going to face the shortage of water being wasted and polluted.
Oh, come on. That's just a tiny, tiny bit. Don't lecture me on that.
He is right, Suhan. We should all save water in little bit by like shutting that tap or brush our teeth or shower for 2-3 minutes less or by using water used to wash vegetables to water plants.
And our moms can wash a full load of machine just in a handful. It would save gallons and gallons of water.
As they say in Hindi, boon boon se sagar banta hai. Ah, now Hindi man would be proud of me to remember that.
I'm sorry friends, thanks to you both, I have learned today that we should save water. In fact, Mom was also telling us that how we should not pollute our beaches by throwing rubbish as plastic and glass in the sea or pollute our rivers. Once it is polluted, it kills both the fishes and aqua plants by cutting the oxygen supply. Thank you, friends. You have corrected my mistake on time.
I'm guilty too. I've so many times left the tap open when I'm brushing my teeth. I'll be more careful henceforth.
Thank you. I know all his dialogues. I'll show you.
Yes,
you got the answer question. Today, we grade 3 students are going to be playing KVC with you all. Is that not exciting?
Yes.
But hello, Vedan. We are not playing KVC out here. Welcome to our new game show called Who Wants to Be the Triple R Star? Oh, as usual, our co-hosts have not given us all the details. Let me explain them. I'm actually on second thoughts, I don't know. So, is everybody ready?
Yes.
Okay, let me explain. The format is exactly like KVC. But there's one difference that there'll be team A and there'll be team B. Remember, your team A and your team B.
You also remember our last year's book. Sasha.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8
in team and 10 in team. What is the best
way to deal with our rubbish?
Donating would be an example of
Yes!
team B.
Glass can be recycled without alteration how many times?
Continuously.
We are not going to give marks for this, huh? Because the students are going to say answer. No.
Yeah, this is it. I just heard.
Okay.
Hey, but I didn't hear that. Yeah.
Okay, next.
The recycle level has?
Team A.
Team A.
हो सकता है। हमारा कूड़ा भी दो प्रकार का होता है,
बायोडिग्रेडेबल नॉन बायोडिग्रेडेबल बायोडिग्रेडेबल कूड़े को खाद या कंपोस्ट से बदल सकते हैं जो कि मिट्टी को उपजाऊ बनाता है। दूसरी ओर नॉन बायोडिग्रेडेबल कूड़ा वे है जो कभी भी मिट्टी में नहीं मिल सकता। वह बहुत हानिकारक है जैसे पुराने इलेक्ट्रॉनिक प्लास्टिक बोतल आदि।
नॉन बायोडिग्रेडेबल कचरे को रिसाइकलिंग प्लांट में ले जाया जा सकता है जहां इनसे दोबारा नई चीजें जैसे खिलौने बोतलें बाल्टी आदि बना सकते हैं।
हमें अपने घरों में कचरा डालने के लिए दो डब्बे रखने चाहिए, एक बायोडिग्रेडेबल हरे रंग का और एक नॉन बायोडिग्रेडेबल नीले रंग का, ताकि सफाई कर्मचारी भी उसे अलग अलग ले जा सकती है।
हम सब लोग वेस्ट चीजों के साथ में नई चीजें और खूबसूरत चीजें बना सकते हैं, जैसे कि बटन्स, बॉटल कैप्स, पिस्ता शेल्स, अखरोट की शेल्स और थोड़ी और चीजों पेंट्स के साथ में उससे एक बटरफ्लाई बना सकते हैं। और एक और आइडिया से हम ये भी बना सकते हैं।
जी हाँ, अपनी कला का प्रयोग करके हम बहुत सुंदर चीजें बना सकते हैं।
इस प्रकार कूड़े को उपयोगी चीजें में बदल सकते हैं और अपने शहर को एक कचरे का ढेर बनाने से रोक सकते हैं और उससे बना सकते हैं एक सुंदर शहर।
जैसे अपनी पुरानी किताबें फेंके नहीं, उसे किसी गरीब बच्चे को दे दे जिसे उनकी जरूरत हो। साथ ही हमें किसी दूसरे की पुरानी किताबें प्रयोग करने से मना ना करें।
हाँ बिल्कुल, भले ही हम नई किताबें खरीद सकते हैं, हमारे पास बहुत पैसा है, फिर भी यदि हमारा काम पुरानी किताब से हो सकता है तो हमें नई किताब नहीं खरीदनी चाहिए, उसी से अपना काम चला लेना चाहिए, क्योंकि हमारे ये छोटे छोटे कदम बहुत सारे पेड़ों को कटने से बचा लेंगे।
हमें सोचना होगा कि ये खूबसूरत दुनिया हमारे लिए हम मनुष्य के लिए है, ना कि कचरे कूड़े के लिए। हमें इस धरती माँ को फिर से उसके वास्तविक स्वरूप में लाना होगा।
यदि हमने इस कचरे को हमारी इस अमूल्य धरती पर ही छोड़ दिया तो हमारी धरती पूरी तरह नष्ट हो जाएगी, पूरे के पूरे शहर डरावने हो जाएंगे कचरे के ढेर जैसे।
हम सारी चीजें सरकार के भरोसे ही नहीं छोड़ सकते कि मोदी जी आएंगे और हमारा कचरा अलग अलग करेंगे। आखिर एक जागरूक नागरिक होने के नाते हमारा भी कुछ कर्तव्य है।
क्या हम आपसे आशा कर सकते हैं कि आप इन तीन सूत्रों रिड्यूस, रियूज और रिसाइकल का पालन अपने अपने कार्य क्षेत्र में करेंगे? आप सब ने अपना अमूल्य समय हमको दिया। आप सबको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।